Java certifications. Is it worth getting Java certified? Let's talk about that in today's video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day, and we're talking about Java certifications. Are they useful? Is it worth you spending the money getting Java certified? The short answer is yes, it is. Thank you for watching. Bye for now. I'm kidding. No, but seriously, it is very important to look at these things, you know, really from a strategic point of view and think, is it worth me spending the money to get Java certified? Firstly, you make the decision whether it is, but secondly, is the certification I'm taking going to be approved by and accepted by the industry? Now, there's a lot of certificates that look great and they've got great marketing behind them, but if the industry in general, in other words, your prospective employers, they don't recognize that as something that is of value, then you're probably wasting your money. The great thing is that the Oracle Java certification process is industry recognized. So in general, if you've got a Java certification from Oracle for Java, that's gonna really stand yourself in good stead, and it's gonna be seen as something really valuable. It's gonna really add to your resume. But there's a lot of other certifications out there that aren't. Now, one of the negatives about getting Java certified through Oracle is the cost. Now, I haven't got the exact prices, but I think last time I checked, it was around about $300+ US to become certified. So you might look at that and think, wow, that's really expensive. But factor in a couple of things when you're deciding on if this is too expensive for you. Firstly, it's pretty hard to cheat the Java certification. And the reason is that you need to take an exam to get your Java certification. And in the case of Oracle's, that requires you to basically attend a physical place. A university is a common place, or a college. And someone has to watch you take that, and you need to prove who you are, show those credentials. So for a lot of those reasons, it's much harder to actually cheat. And if you think about it, also the fact that basically they need to get someone there to actually watch you take the test, presumably they're being paid for that. So there's a portion of that cost that is being outlaid for you to take that exam. Then because of that process, it's being harder to cheat, and because the contents of the certification the contents in the exam can be quite hard if you haven't studied Java properly, it's seen as a positive thing. So if you've got that certification, it proves that you know Java to a certain level, and it proves that you have yourself taken that exam, and you know, you haven't cheated your way. Because if you think about it, online exam, let's just just assume that where there's a certification out there that was online only, you didn't need to prove who you were. You could just spend the money, take it. Now, what's to say you didn't cheat? What's to say you didn't just look up the answers as you went through it all and, you know, wow, I got 100%. Wow, how good am I? When in reality, you've cheated. So an employer, chances are they'll be aware of that, and they would validate any certifications you have in the sense that they'll check and see where it comes from. So in other words, if you say you're Java certified from XYZ company, someone, when you're going to get that programming job, will likely at some point try and verify XYZ company to see whether they are reputable. But in the case of Oracle, getting back to the Java Oracle program certification, Java certification, it's a recognized thing, because Oracle being the creators of Java, or now the owners, not the creators, but they're seen as being a positive thing. They're seen as something that people can adopt, and you know, it's a great thing to add to your resume, is what I'm trying to say. So I think personally it's worth the money if you're struggling to get your first programming job, or you want to get a better job. Now, there's multiple levels of certifications as well. And the other thing to keep in mind is that with the release of JDK 11, there's now a newer course that's just come out fairly recently. I think it came out late March 2019. That's the Java 11 certification. Now, with my Learn Programming Academy, I've already got a Java certification program, a best-selling Java course on Udemy. So there's a link in the description. You can click on that to check that course out in more details. And that covers JDK 8, in other words, Java version 8. And that was the stable version of Java for many years. And these days, now that the newer versions of Java have come out, Oracle have now updated their training and very recently have released the Java 11 certification process. And I'm actually in the process of creating a new course for that. So in the next, probably the next 6 to 8 weeks, as of the date I'm shooting this video, I'll have that course released. So if you're looking to get Java 11 certified, then I suggest you hang on and wait for that course, and that'll help you go through the process. And without getting too much, I don't want to make this a salesy type video, but what I want to let you know is that in terms of the type of course that I'm generating, for Java 11, I'm focusing on what you need to know. So I've got two Java courses already. I've got the Java Masterclass and the Java Crash Course, both on Udemy. Links also in the description of this video. Now, they teach you how to use Java. And they're aimed for someone who's got no experience, how to learn programming, how to learn Java. Now, the Java certification course that I'm working on is going to teach you how to pass the exam. So it's not trying to teach you Java, it's trying to teach you what you need, the gotchas, the tricks and techniques that they use in some of the exam questions are going to be covered in that course. So keep that in mind, that it's very important that you know these things when you go into those exams. But anyway, we'll talk more about that in future videos. Getting back to Java certification though in general, I think it's very valuable for the reasons that I've outlined. Because it's seen as something of value by the industry in general, adding it to your resume can be the difference between you getting a job and not getting a job. So I think it's worthwhile. If you've got the funds and you can afford it, make it a priority to get Java certified, and it's going to be something you'll have forever. And the other thing is, even in the, as future versions of Java actually come out, you can upgrade your certification to the newer version at a cheaper price and paying for the full price for the exam again, for that certification, for that version again. So it can still be valuable right now to get Java 8 training, and you'll pay a much cheaper price to upgrade that to Java 11. And the good thing is then you can say you're certified in both Java 8 and Java 11. So you can see there's pros and cons there. I'm rambling, so I'm going to stop now. Thanks for watching. Let's move on now to another video. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.